Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. So we're gonna get started with the P. Louise base in the shade Rumor 3. And I just like using this under my brows when I'm doing a cut crease because the colors come out more vivid when you use the P. Louise base. And I'm gonna go ahead and put that on my lid. You don't have to work it all over because I'm gonna wipe the P. Louise base off my lid when I'm done packing on that color of the red. I'm gonna use 39L Hit the Lights palette by Morphe, and I'm using this red, and I'm gonna place that in my natural crease and blend it out with my Morphe M504 brush. And then I'm gonna take the red right next to it from the Morphe palette and put it in the same place and use the Morphe M504 brush again to blend it. And it helps to lift your eyebrow up to blend, so you can get everything blended. I'm gonna take my Morphe M321 Bullet Crease Brush, and I'm gonna pack on this bright red and pack that in the crease. After I'm done blending it, I'm gonna go ahead and take a makeup wipe and wipe some of my lid off. I don't want all that red when I cut my crease. I just want a little bit. I'm taking the P. Louise base in the shade Rumor 1, and I'm gonna start carving my crease. I'm using the Morphe M167 brush. I always use that to put the P. Louise base on when I'm ready to cut my crease. And if you have a problem with finding where to expand your crease, just use the circular motion, like the circle part of the brush, to help guide you. And you don't want the crease to go like in front of your eyebrow, and you want it to stop where your eye stops. And if you get stuck while doing this, just remember that you want the crease to be a perfect as you can get circle on your lid. I'm packing some more of the brick red on with my Morphe M321 brush just to make the colors pop more. And then I'm gonna go ahead and blend it out with the Morphe M332 brush. And while you're blending, I like keep rubbing it on my hand so I don't let the red bleed all over. You always want to do that when you're blending with cut creases, just kind of clean your brush as you go. And I'm going back in and just perfecting the crease with some more P. Louise base. And then when you're done putting on the P. Louise base, it's always good to put an eyeshadow down over it, because if you just go in with a glitter, it's gonna be patchy. And then I'm going in the Morphe Boss Smooth palette. I'm going into this glitter, but I didn't really like how this glitter looked, so I only put a little bit on because I already did it to the other eye, so I got to do the same thing to the other one. And then I went into this Beauty Glazed Pressed Glitter palette, and I went and put this glitter on my lid, and I just applied it with my fingers. I used two glitters from this palette, and I just packed it on until my liking. And then I'm going to put on my lashes from AliExpress. I just got these today, so I went ahead and I tried them, and I love them so far. So I'm going ahead and put those on. And this is my same face routine that I always do. Instead of the ABH powder. I use my Morphe powder because it left like a chalky undertone to when I put my concealer on. So I just went back to my Morphe powder. The Morphe powder is a great dupe for the Sasha Cosmetics Buttercup powder. I just know I don't really use the Sasha Buttercup anymore because you can only get that online and Morphe is at Ulta. So I just switched to the Morphe banana powder. And this Juvia's Place loose highlighter is pigmented. I have not, like, even the Fenty Beauty one isn't even this pigmented. Like, I had to take some off because you could see me from the moon. So I had to put on just a little, like, I put on very little. Do not overpower on this Juvia's Place loose highlighter. I went in the Hit the Lights palette and I added this gold into my tear duct because I wanted the look to pop some more and some of the glitter had came off from me blending. I didn't put anything on my waterline. I was tired. It was like midnight. And then I'm putting on brown lip liner and the NYX Liquid Suede Brown Liquid Matte on my lips just a little bit. I didn't want to do nude. I wanted to switch it up this time. And then I put on Smashbox lip gloss and to give me a little glossy look. Well, this is the final look. I hope you all liked it. Everything will be listed in the description box below. Subscribe if you aren't subscribing. Please like. Let me know what other colors you'd like me to do, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.